So before I start with my keying, just let me save this file. I'll be naming this as keying underscore 01 underscore key light underscore 01. So yeah, I've got that. And now if I play this, so if you can see, we are also maintaining or observing this soft shadow over here, which will be maintaining that, as this is actually looking pretty nice. Now the next thing we'll do is we will be keying this out. So just let me somehow drag this up. Zip it up to 100%. Also, I will be closing these tabs here as I do not want them anymore. Yeah, this looks fine to me. So I'll be also showing you this through my info panel over here, which is slightly important. So if you guys see here, if I show you the mat for this, or if I show you the alpha for this, right now this is a cutout over here, as you have seen. So if you see here, your cursor here, if you can see the alpha over here, it says 255. And if I go here, this says 0, which means that this area is 0 over here, which means this is fully transparent, and this area over here is 255, which means this is fully opaque. So the area which is in white is fully opaque, and the area which is in black is totally transparent. So now let's go back to our RGB mode, and now let's go to keying, and then we will be inserting this key light over here. So this has been inserted or applied, this effect has been applied on our keying, which you can see from here. So the option of screen color is right now in black. So let us select this. Though the moment you click this, this eyedropper comes and you got to select here, click on any color you want to. Now very important thing is, if you want to change this from RGB to alpha, and if you want to see the matte, which is this. So this is basically my masked area, which is this. So it's performing keying on this area itself and not the entire screen or the entire footage over here, not on these areas. It is only performing the keying in this area. We have masked this out, as this is my mat. So I'm telling key light or my keyer to perform the keying on this area itself. Now going to my RGB over here, or going to my green over here, it is showing the values which is in green. Let us go back to RGB. So if I go to screen in right now, it's in 100, but still my matte is not fine. If you see my alpha here, I am getting some spills over here, which means that this area over here, if I see this area, it's 255, and if I go here, it's 22. So if you are working on a chroma, your alpha here should be 0. So that's the reason I have opened this info palette and not close this. So if I go here, it's right now in 0. If you notice here, if you see the value over here, it's 0, but if I go here, it says around 20, 21, 22. And suppose if I go zoom in over here, I'm right now in 800% zoom. So almost once in production, if your shot is checked, it is around zoomed up to around 600-700%, because the matte which you generate or you key out has to be pretty much clear, and there should not be any kind of correction or any kind of error in that shot. So right now, if you just send this to my the next department to composite this or to replace it with a background or to place any CG element, they would just throw this out, because the matte over here, as you can see in my alpha, it is not at all clear. There are some spills here, if you can see this, if you can see this. So as this is key light, it gives you pretty many options to control your matte and to make your matte more smoother and more finer. As you can see here, the alpha is right now in 19. If you see it, it's in 50 54 60. So these areas needs to be, of course, dealt with. So for that, key light has given us some options which we'll be looking through this. So if I expand my screen mat over here, there is an option known as clip black. So what does clip black do is, basically it would clip out, or it would make the areas which are semi black or semi transparent into more transparent, So if I increase the value here, if you can see the values, or if you can see the areas over here, I'm just going on increasing the values. It will just clip like that. So from 0, I've taken it to 22. And right now if you, I've taken a snapshot which I do not want. So right now if you go back to RGB, this is what you get. So if I go back to alpha again, and if I see here, if I change this from 22 to 0, if I go here and if I see the alpha over here, it's right now in 20, and if increasing the amount of clip black to 0 to 22, if I go, the alpha is 0. So that's the difference, and that's how to make your matte, make your key light, or make your chroma green screen pretty much sharper and finer. In the same way, if I go here, this is the dress what we have. If I go back to my RGB,